Here it goes.
Alright, here we go. Hold tight, wave your hands in the air like you just don't care. Scream! Hands inside the carriage at all times, please. Health and safety.
Here's one of my favorite old PC games. It's called Pango. It's actually a clone of the game called Pango. Copyright 1983. So let's give it a shot. Now you get the hang of it. I had to pull out my old discs to find this one. It's a game called Lawn Mower. It's a game where you mow the lawn. And it's pretty fun because they have different obstacles on the lawn. And if you hit too many things, you have to go back to the shed to get a new blade. And if you take too long, you won't be paying anything. It's all in text mode, but it's pretty fun. Gonna need a new blade soon. If you hit the animal, you have to go back to the shed to get a new mower. See, you're on the second mower. Object is to obviously mow all the grass, and there's three different lawns total. Now it needs a new blade, so you have to go back to the shed. And so forth. It's pretty fun. Certainly unique. Here's a clone of Frogger called Ribbit. Turn on color monitor. It already is on. Not a very good clone at all, but it's playable at least. Get your timing right. Here's the first ever version of Tetris. Copyright 1986 USSR. Those are the two programmers. Start level 0. Thank you. I love this keyboard. You get the hang of it. It's all in text mode, of course. Enter your name. The Westlife. Once more, no. And several years later, this was the Spectrum Holobyte version of Tetris. With much fancier graphics. It was very popular, but they didn't give proper royalties to original authors, so I think they actually got sued over this. See, 1987, 1 year later. See, they showed completely different programmers. They don't give any credit to the original creators of Tetris. Map of the old USSR there. This one also supports a joystick, which I do have, but I don't have hooked up right now. And this one also does Tandy graphics. So if I play this on my Tandy, I get the full 16 colors, which looks a lot better than this. And you can step up to the next levels, different graphics as you go along. Faster as you go through the levels. Even on the original PC, the top level is pretty much unplayable because it's so fast. So if you play this on like a 386, it'll just go blip 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 and you can't even do anything. Do you want to play again? No.